while the Chiefs look to go to 3-0, meaning return to strike two scored. Earlier today, Atlanta held on despite the interception thrown by Matt Ryan to win on a controversial ending against the Lions. The Eagles won on a 61-yard field goal by the rookie Jake Elliott. Minnesota got 97 yards rushing and 72 receiving from Dalvin Cook. Case also had a big day as they beat Tampa Bay. The Saints hand New Orleans or Carolina its first loss. Baltimore, four touchdown passes from Jake Bortles as they went in London. Tom Brady, five TD passes, including the game where with 23 seconds left as the Patriots eke out a win against Houston. Denver loses for the first time this year. Buffalo, 2-1. And the Steelers, in overtime, fall to the Chicago Bears, 23-17, the final. And that one, Jets get their first win of the year. Same story for the Indianapolis Colts as they beat the Cleveland Browns. That game that everyone just saw here on Fox. Tennessee Titans ran for 195 yards and taking care of Seattle. Seattle now 1-2 on the season with that loss. And suddenly you take a look at
who's running away with that division?
The LA Rams are in first place. How about this performance by Seattle today? This is one of the, you thought that, okay, they turned around and this was, you know, one of those things where they went in there trying to stop the run.
It's on the road, and Tennessee has a definitive identity. And, you know, we're tough, you're tough, let's get it on, let's see who's the tougher in the matchup. And the Tennessee Titans offensive line, they put a lot of bodies in play, and they don't set the edge here. Henry, that's a 247-pound running back, hitting the edge for an explosive play, and hard outside. And to me, late in the game in particular, we saw in Green Bay when they were on the field too much in the first half. In the second half, they wore down and you see the explosive plays. We thought it was an anomaly versus San Francisco with Carlos Hyde, but it's coming back to haunt them. In the second half, they start to fade. And when fatigue sets in, that's when the big runs hit.
Yeah, it's kind of like that boxing match. Yep. And you body blow, and then you just wear down, yep, and you hit the knockout punch in the second half. But on the other side of that, the Seattle running the football, they couldn't do it. It was atrocious. And Russell Wilson is back there throwing the ball 49 times, 29 to 49. It's had a career day for passing yards, but you don't want that out of Russell Wilson. You want to be able to balance that with the running attack, with Russell Wilson's ability to scramble, use his legs to make offensive plays, along with great defense, keep that defense off the field, and that's the recipe for success that Seattle's had over the years.
What was the identity of their Super Bowl
defense? Run the football.
Great defense.
Yeah.
They've gotten away from that.
Yeah, they couldn't really do either today. Meanwhile, Tennessee, they did run the football well, played good enough defense, and got a good play from their quarterback, Marcus Mariota. They get the win, Mariota with Pam Oliver.
Okay, thanks a lot. Boy, Marcus, that first half is nothing to write home about. How did you guys just stay with it and keep plodding and keep going to turn that into a really nice second half?
I give a lot of credit to the coaches. They made some adjustments for us. Guys up front played well. You know, guys outside made a bunch of plays, and this is a good win for us.
One thing you hear about, and I heard this from Mike at halftime, it's like, wait a second, we don't blink and we don't flinch. So what about coming back from adversity in whatever form that is in a ball game that speaks to what you guys are?
Well, we just focus on each other. You know, the main goal for us is to play and play for each other. And if we continue to do that, I think that same mentality will create success.
Appreciate it, Marcus.
Thank you very much.
All right, so that wraps up our coverage here in Week 3. We will see you again next Sunday as we get you ready for Week 4. Tony Gonzalez, part of Fox NFL Kickoff, 11 o'clock Eastern. We will be here for Fox NFL Sunday at noon Eastern.
Terry Jones back to the Senior Center.
See you next Sunday. It's Sunday's most dependable plays of the day. We're almost to the finish line of Week 3, and after another classic comeback, last-second thrillers, and controversial finishes, this week proved that the NFL season is in full swing. But don't get too confident, or you might fall flat. Brought to you by Chevrolet, the most dependable plays of the day.
Fox Sports thanks you for watching this presentation of the National Football League. For NFL news and highlights, go to NFL.com.
Behind every seat is a story. Behind every story is the reason for transparency.
Talkin' Huskies, Friday at 11 on Q13 Fox.
Whether you're a morning person, or you're that person who just makes everyone's morning brighter, there's McDonald's for every morning.
Right now, get two of your favorite breakfast sandwiches for just $5.
Would you charge your neighbor a fee for a cup of flour?
No.
Nope.
Mm-mm, no.
Definitely not.
Of course you wouldn't. You're not out to gouge people, and neither is BECU, which is why we offer checking with no monthly maintenance fees or hidden charges. None. It's not banking the way a bank would do it. It's banking the way you do it. Because at BECU, you own it.
You connect theater with Blu-ray player, built-in games, and apps.
Impressive.
Nauseating.
No wonder it won that J.D. Power Quality Award, right?
No wonder.
Are you doing that inner monologue thing again?
No.
Yes. I'm growing a higher hedge.
Now get 0% APR financing for 60 months in the 2017 Chrysler Pacifica.
The numbers you see are pretty uncharacteristic, but they were a reality today. The Seahawks falling to the Tennessee Titans 33-27. More than 850 total yards of offense combined in this one. The Seahawks giving up 195 rushing yards. The Seahawks also with 11 penalties as Seattle loses its sixth consecutive road game in the month of September, dating all the way back to 2013. The Hawks now 1-2 on the regular season with a primetime home game next Sunday night. This is Seahawks Game Day alongside former Seahawks Jordan Babineau and Dave Wyman. I'm Aaron Levine. We'll have reaction from head coach Pete Carroll as soon as he takes the podium. On Ian Furness also standing by in Nashville with reaction from the players. But there's no question, guys, a frustrating start to the season and uncharacteristic football at times for the Seahawks.
Yeah, well, let's go through, let's start with the positives, okay? I got some positive things here, Jordan. They didn't turn the ball over, okay? Russell was only sacked one time. They put 433 yards of offense. They were 3-for-4 in the red zone. They held the Titans to 0-for-3 in the red zone, which Titans were one of the better red zone teams. And they had 5 plays over 20 yards on offense. They love those big explosive plays. But here's the bad news. They gave up 195 yards rushing. This is the fifth time now that they've given up a 100-yard rusher since 2012. And twice it's been DeMarco Murray. And then, you know, they just gave up a lot of big plays, 4 huge plays over 20 yards. And 3 of them went for touchdowns. So that was difficult. And then they also only ran for 69 yards. So this team is just not, I mean, they're not where they're going to be this year right now. Teams evolve in the NFL. And right now, they're not playing their best football by any stretch of the imagination. So I'm sorry that I predicted a Tennessee win in the pregame. But I thought it was going to be it's one of those difficult games. You look at it on the schedule, it was going to be tough to go in there and get a win. So some things to like, but it was definitely disappointing to most Seahawks fans.
Yeah, and I would say, you know, one of the things that the Seahawks did or didn't do defensively is they didn't adjust as fast as the Tennessee Titans did. Offensively, you saw that the Titans had a creative game plan, and they really switched things up. They went to a more off-the-tackle type of running style, and those simply were fits. It just seemed that to me that the curl player or the contained player didn't maintain the integrity of the defense, forcing that ball back to the interior defensive lineman. And then the adjustment with the design Marcus Mariota runs, we saw that they went to an off tackle and an extra offensive lineman, and it created some mismatches there. So you got to give the Titans credit because they put together a great offensive game plan. And DeMarco Murray, as you mentioned, he's faced this tough Seahawks defense before with the Dallas Cowboys when they were here at CenturyLink Field. And he rushed for over 100 yards, did it again today.
Let's go back to Nissan Stadium in Nashville, Tennessee, where Ian Furness standing by with Cliff Haber. Ian?
Thanks a lot, Aaron. Cliff, this is not Seahawks football. I'll just ask you a very simple question. What happened?
I mean, there's a lot of things that happened today. We had a decent first half on defense, but we gave us some things that are not like us ourselves from the long runs and different things like that. But the cool thing is we have a lot of football to be played, and they're all corrections that we need to make and we can make.
Big plays, too. too. That doesn't happen often against this team. Is that just a breakdown, one guy, one, two guys? What happens on those big plays?
Just got to go back and watch the film. I'm not sure where the communication, miscommunication, or what guys aren't getting over, what the D-line isn't doing. We just got to go watch film and everybody look themselves in the mirror and see how they can make the team better.
Strange game, because the first four series combined for the two teams were 3 and outs. And then all of a sudden, you look at the numbers at the end, you guys give up almost 200 yards on the ground. Again, that's just not what happens here.
No, that's not like ourselves at all. I mean, the last 2 weeks have been uncharacteristic of us. Trust me, all the guys on the defense are heated, especially all the guys that have been here, because we don't do that. That's not what we do, and we'll get back to what we do, which is, stopping the run and getting after the pass rush.
There's a lot of emotion out there. Did you guys lose your cool a couple times as well, or is that just part of football?
It's just part of football. I wouldn't dig too deep into that. It's part of football, a bunch of grown men that aren't happy with the way the game is going, and sometimes it gets chippy, but it means nothing.
The story, obviously, is what happened before the game, and both teams come to an agreement. Can you take us through that as well? Because a lot of people are curious about what the decision was to stay in the locker room, and it was done as well, it sounds like, with Tennessee.
Yeah, it was both of us, both teams decided to make a stand and step up and, just different topics that obviously that's going on in our country right now, and both teams decided what they wanted to do. As a team, we had meetings and